What is a storyboard? A storyboard is a sequential visual representation of a film, video, or animation, typically comprising a series of sketches or images that depict key scenes and camera angles. Today, I will show you three ways to make storyboards within minutes using Katalist AI. We are in the Katalist AI home screen now. We are diving into this thing called the AI Script Assistant. Basically, this is where the magic happens. You just toss in your idea, anything really, and let the AI do its thing. So I have got this one-liner of an idea, kind of an intriguing premise, I think. Let me type it in here. Now we are gonna see what the AI cooks up. I'm hitting this generate script button and we just wait a few seconds. Just like that, we have got a script breakdown. It's taken my little idea and turned it into a whole scene with dialogue and everything. We are talking scene descriptions, character actions, the whole thing. You can see the character names John and Emily. It's like it's taken the seed of an idea and grown it into a full-fledged script. Pretty neat. Here we got a bunch of different orientation presets for our storyboard. There's also an edit button right here. So if you need to tweak anything in your script, you can do it right here and it will update the storyboard. Pretty flexible. Okay, so I'm gonna hit next and that takes us to the style section. This is where we really start to have some fun. Check out all these different styles for your storyboard. You've got everything from super clean and minimalist to more artistic and illustrative styles. You can also actually create your own custom style. If you have some images that you want to use as inspiration or even upload your own artwork, you can totally do that. It's a great way to make your storyboards truly unique. For this one, I think I'm gonna go with cinematic. It just feels right for this project. So I'm selecting cinematic and now I'm hitting next and we should be good to go. So now we have landed on the cache screen. This is where we start bringing our characters to life visually. Now, because we already did the script breakdown, the AI has automatically populated our cache based on the script. We have two characters here for this script, John and Emily, the main characters for this little story. Now we have made it to the storyboard section. This is where things really start to get visual and we see our story coming to life. So up here at the top, we have got access to each of our characters. You can click on any of them. Let's say we pick John here and you can actually go in and change their appearance. You know, give them a different hairstyle, swap out their outfit, whatever you need to do to get them just right. You can even change the name if you suddenly decide they should be called something else. It's totally flexible. And get this, if you need to add more characters to your story, there's an option to do that right here as well. So if your script suddenly calls for a new face, you can easily bring them into the storyboard. Okay, so after a few seconds of letting the AI do its thing, you've got a full-on storyboard complete with pictures for each line of our script. It's pretty amazing how quickly it generates all of this. And if you feel like you need to add more to a particular scene or extend the story beyond what's already there, you can totally add extra frames. It gives you complete control over the pacing and visuals of your storyboard. It's like having a digital drawing board where you can add, remove, and rearrange things as much as you want. Let's say I want to make some tweaks to this specific visual right here. I'm gonna click on it. It pops up bigger. And now we have got a whole bunch more options to play with. This is where we can really fine-tune things. You can actually edit the script line right here if you need to. You can also change the location of the scene and mess around with the shot style and selection. There are tons of ways to customize each frame. But I want to show you this cool feature, the character posing tool. This is pretty neat. Basically, what it does is it shows these connected dots in the shape of our characters. Think of it like a digital puppet. And if you double click on the character to go into edit mode, we can actually move these dots around. It's like manipulating a little digital skeleton and it lets us change the character's pose. So let's say I want to try and raise this guy's left hand. I'm just gonna experiment here, moving these points around, trying to get his arm up. Okay, let's see what we get. Alright, so now we have got 4 extra images to choose from. This is where the AI generates a few different options based on the pose we created. Now, as you can see, there's sometimes this little quirk with AI image generation, especially when it comes to things like hands and fingers. Sometimes they can look a little of. And yeah, we are seeing a bit of that here too. Hopefully, that's something that will get improved over time as the AI gets better. But it's still pretty impressive what it can do. I want to show you another cool tool, the generative fill tool. This is awesome for adding extra elements to your scene. So I'm going to grab the brush tool here. And let's say I want to add some extra kids playing soccer in the background. I'm just brushing over the area where I want them to be, and the AI is going to generate some options for us. And there we go. We've got a few different options with kids playing soccer. I'm going to pick the one that looks the best, and remember, we still have the option to alter the script on the go. Alright, so now we have made these changes, I'm going to save this frame. The changes are now reflected in our storyboard. It's all updated and ready to go. Now you're ready to show it off to a client or your team. Well, there are a bunch of ways you can do that right here. You've got this handy presentation mode, which is perfect for showcasing your work in a really professional way. If you click on it, you'll see we have got a couple of different options. There's the slideshow mode, which lets you present your storyboard frame by frame, kind of like a digital flipbook. And then we have also got the grid mode, which gives you a nice overview of the entire storyboard at once. We're gonna bring another AI tool into the mix, ChatGPT. Here's what I've got. I've got this basic idea for a story, and I'm going to head over to ChatGPT. I'm gonna type in a command to create a storyline based on my idea. I'm also going to add a couple of extra requirements, you know, things like the tone or the setting, just to give ChatGPT a little more direction. Okay, let's see what it comes up with. And there we go. ChatGPT has generated a storyline for us, complete with a character named Elena. This is just a basic storyline. We need a more detailed script. So I'm going to tell ChatGPT to expand on this storyline and create a full script structured into a series of scenes. I'm also going to give it some more specific instructions. Look at that. ChatGPT has now given us a fully structured script with different numbered scenes. It's got scene descriptions, character actions too. It's taken our initial idea and turned it into a ready-to-go script. Now, here's another neat trick. If you want to export this script as a CSV file, all you have to do is type export as CSV to ChatGPT. And just like that, CSV file for our script is ready to be downloaded. So we got our script in a nice clean CSV format, ready to be used in Katalist AI. So we're going to use this upload script option right here. And now we just need to choose the CSV file that we just downloaded. Okay, so now Katalist AI has pulled in all the data from our CSV file. You can see all the details here, the scene numbers, descriptions, everything. Now we need to tell Katalist AI which column in our CSV file contains the actual script text. In this case, it's the column with the header description. So we're going to select that and then click import. And there we go. We are now ready to start creating our storyboard based on the script we generated with ChatGPT. Now this time around, I think I'm going to go for a different visual style. So I'm going to choose the comic book style option. Let's see how this looks. Okay, so we have got our initial storyboard frames. This first frame looks a little odd. We can try to fix that. I'm just going to try changing the location for this scene and see if that helps. And I will apply that change. Alright, that's much better. Now it's starting to look like a proper comic book panel. So there you have it. And now our storyboard is ready to be presented. It's been a pretty smooth and efficient process. Let me now show you a quick and easy way to whip up a storyboard specifically for an ad. So I've got this tagline for a tomato sauce ad that I actually got from ChatGPT in the script breakdown in Katalist AI. Let me just quickly check if everything looks good. Okay, so the first thing I'm gonna do is choose a style for our storyboard. For this ad, I think the animation style will work really well. It will give it a nice, vibrant feel. Now we've got our characters here, Maria and Luca. Take a look at them. I think they're perfect for this ad. Now I got an idea. I think it would be cool to actually visualize the tin of tomato sauce in one of these frames. It would really help to sell the product and give the client a clear idea of what we are going for. So I'm going to try using the generative fill tool on this bottle here. Okay, so I'm brushing over the bottle and now I'm going to type in my prompt, a can of tomato sauce. You can also add negative prompts, which are basically things you don't want the AI to include in the generated image. It's a good way to refine the results. Alright, so we've got four options to choose from. Let's see. I think this one looks pretty good. It's got a nice recognizable shape and it looks pretty close to some branded tins you might see on the shelves. So I'm gonna go with this one. Perfect, it blends in really well with the scene. Now I'm gonna save this frame and take a look at the overall storyboard. It looks really well refined now. It's amazing how quickly you can create something like this. This is such a nice way to get ideas on how to frame your shots and really visualize the flow of your ad. It's a great tool for brainstorming and getting everyone on the same page. So that's just a quick example of how you can use Katalist AI to create a storyboard for an ad. I'll leave the link in the description for you to try Katalist AI for free. Hope this video was useful to you all and subscribe for more. Thanks for watching.